Hi there, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, thank you for pressing play. Ensure you don't leave the channel without becoming a subscriber. I love you, thank you very much. And if you're an old subscriber, thank you for always returning. I love, love, love you. Thank you. All right, in today's video, I'm going to be taking you through how I create puzzles for games that I create during social gatherings. I mentioned this in the last video that I uploaded. If you have not watched it, I'm going to link it down in the description box. And I'm also going to take you through how I manipulate the process to create picture frames. Without further ado, let's jump right in. Alright, these are some of the things I'm going to be needing for this process. I'm going to be needing the scissors, the ruler, the pencil. I'm going to be using a biro at some point. The top bond, which is a glue I'm going to be using. Then the cardboard, which is just a carton of noodles. Yes. Okay, I'm using the tray to serve like a place where I put the thing so that I don't get dirt on my mattress because I'm currently filming on my mattress. Okay, so I cut the edges of the carton in order to get a more uniform rectangle, and then from that rectangle I'm going to be cutting out an 8x8 square shape. Now what I'm doing is just taking my measurement on the cardboard. I'm just marking my points just so I can get a more uniform square. All right, now I'm joining the points together. If you do it this way, you get something that is more uniform rather than have like a wobbly square or a square that looks more like a parallelogram, if you get what I mean. After that, I'm going to cut out that square, and then I'm going to cut out another square. So I've cut out the first one, so I'm going to cut out another of the same size. Just by placing it on the remaining cardboard, I don't need to use the ruler now. Just trace it out and cut it out. Now that I have my two square pieces, I'm going to create a border on one of it. So I'm using the smoother one, the one that looks more sturdy or more firm. I would advise that if you have a thicker cardboard, you should use that instead of something more soft. So a double corrugated carton would make more sense than this. But this is all I have to work with it. Now I'm just trying to create borders around that square, one of the squares. And the border, I'm not using a particular measurement, I'm just using the width of the ruler to create the border. That way it's more uniform. Just follow what I'm doing, the process. I think the width of this ruler is about 1 inch. It's about 1 inch or 1.5 inch. After creating the border, I cut out the inner square. If you have like a knife, it will be easier to just cut it out without having to open up the other square, the external square, the border that you created. I'm using the scissors to cut this, so I have to kind of open up one end in order to get the inner square out. This is what I am left with after cutting it out, and then I place that on the other square, the complete one, the one I did not do anything on, and then I glue it together. I'm going to be using my top bond to glue it, so I just put the glue all around the edges. And then I place it on the other shape, the other square shape. I'm bringing back the tray because I don't want to get glue on my mattress. I mean, after filming, I still have to sleep, right? That's it. Okay, because I'm doing this in such a hurry, I'm just getting things all messed up. Ideally, you just have to be more careful in order not to get glue all over the place. All right. I'm now going to place it carefully, ensure that it is well aligned, because if you do not align it properly, then the inner square becomes very small. And then when you create your puzzle pieces, because you're going to be creating the puzzle pieces with the other square, the inner one you cut out, and when you create that one, it won't be able to fit in if you make this, if you do not glue properly, if you glue it such that it's too small or too tight. Okay, now I'm going to be creating the puzzle pieces. This method is like the easiest method when creating puzzle pieces because you just have to draw different kind of lines and form different shapes. So I'm just drawing different lines. Some will come out as rectangle, some will come out as a parallelogram, some will come out as a trapezoid, some will come out as a triangle, just different shape. It could be isosceles triangle, it could be equilateral, it could just be different shape, it could be a right angle triangle. There'll just be different shapes coming out just by drawing different lines from different points on the square. Alright, this is what I have. So I have how many pieces? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pieces of puzzles. And now I'm going to... So you can just design this. You could play around this and then arrange it back into the frame that you've created. In order to make this frame like look more distinguished from the puzzle pieces, I'm going to use the paper tape to kind of design the edges. That's the thing. Another thing you can do is just create doodles. If you're someone that likes to doodle, you can doodle around the edges of the frame, or you could just use like a fabric to do the edges, or instead use a duct tape to design the edges. Just something that differentiates the frame or the puzzle board from the puzzle pieces, if that makes sense. And now I said you could create picture frames using this method. Instead of you creating puzzle pieces with the square you cut out, you could just place a picture on top of that and then insert it into this frame, and voila, you already have your picture frame ready, if it makes sense. Alright, I'm going to be showing you an example of picture frames or wall art that I've made using the same method. Okay, now I'm trying to arrange the puzzle pieces. When I cannot even remember the order in which I cut it again, so I'm just trying to work around this. But because I am the one that did it, I could kind of figure out the way it's supposed to be. When I created a puzzle like this for one of the social gatherings, it took the people that were participating a very long time to solve the puzzle, and they didn't even end up getting it. I had to show them the pictures, and then they have to memorize the pictures, how the shapes are arranged before they could get it. And even at that, one of the participants still did not get it. So it's really a fun way to enjoy, and it's festive season, it's holiday season. You could enjoy the moment with your family and friends. Right now, I'm just trying to get the shape back. Just working around things. Enjoy me trying to arrange this. Sometimes it doesn't fit in properly, and that means that I have not arranged it well enough, you know, because it's a cutout. You have to kind of make it fit so much, so you have to fit it to look as seamless as possible so that every piece fits properly. When I created this piece for the first social gathering I attended, it was the second social gathering, when I created the puzzle that I made, that I'll be showing you shortly, I kind of taped each pieces, and then it did not fit into the puzzle, but I had to trim it off, and it was a lot of work, so just work around it. Alright, this is one of the puzzle pieces that I created, and it's a 9 pieces a 9-piece puzzle. As you can see, it's arranged now. I'm going to kind of remove all the puzzle pieces and try to rearrange it. Puzzle board was created with a double corrugated cardboard, so it's thicker than the other one that I just created. Alright, the reason why I actually taped the puzzle pieces, why I taped each puzzle piece, was actually to create a pattern. And aside from creating a pattern, I also wanted you can see that dot on the rust mark on the puzzle board. I didn't want it to be a guide for people that were solving the puzzle to easily get, so I had to use the tape to cover up the marks, if you get that. Okay, another thing, so you creating a pattern is a way participants can get, people playing the game or arranging the puzzle can get it done. Or you could actually, if you're good at drawing, you could draw a image on the square piece before cutting out, and that way people have a pattern to follow. If you're enjoying this so far, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel, and as well comment. Alright, this is another one that I created as well. It's a little bit different. It's not just lines. You form shapes, and these shapes are more of a, I don't know what to call it. It's more like a, it's not 3D, it's not, I don't know if it's 2D or what to call it, but it's different. It's not just a plain shape. It has more dimension to it. It looks, some forms like alphabets, like letter L, T, just different things. And then there are still some rectangles. You can see this one, it looks different. So you can also make pieces like this. So I already said, I've mentioned that you can make one where you kind of have an image drawn on the piece before cutting it out, so that you can, so that people that are solving the puzzle can have like a hint or a guide to do it. Or you have to show them the pattern and then help, have them memorize this pattern before going to arrange it, so that it's easier for them to arrange. Or you could just leave them to keep playing around it until they get it. Anyhow you want it, just do it. All right so this is the one I created, and you can design it any way you want. And now to making it into frames, you can see, so the inner square I cut out, I just kind of placed another image that I drew on it, and then I inserted it into the framework. I glued it down, although you can try not to glue it down so that you can always remove and replace, and then I placed it on the wall. If you want to see other easier ways you can create puzzle for an event or for any activities at all, leave a comment down in the comment section and I will do just that. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, especially if you enjoyed this video. Love you. Until next time.